your business process has reached a performance level beyond which it is unable to improve any further. After reaching this level of performance, even if you try to do a Six Sigma project, your business metrics do not improve. What to do in this situation? This is what we will discuss in this video. We will talk about a technique called Business Process Reengineering, popularly known as BPR. We will discuss what is BPR, when and why is it used. We will further discuss an example of BPR, and finally, we will compare BPR with Six Sigma. So let's begin. BPR is all about the radical redesign of your business process. In other words, in a BPR project, the steps in a business process before executing the project would never remain the same after the project is completed. One of the key characteristics of a BPR project is that it is always technology driven. In fact, a BPR project is characterized by the heavy dependence on technology. The business process undergoes a major technological overhaul. A BPR project is executed when the process reaches its saturation level of performance. What do you mean by reaching the saturation level of performance? Let's take an example. If your business process is performing at an accuracy score of 95%, you want to improve this accuracy score from 95 to 98% or even 100%. However, whatever actions you incorporate, the accuracy score does not improve. It continues to stay at 95%. It may improve marginally, but comes back to 95%. When you are in a situation like this, where your process has reached the maximum limit of performance levels, and whatever you do, it doesn't go beyond that level, this situation is termed as the saturation level of your business performance. These processes, which have reached their saturation level of performance, are ideal to incorporate BPR. Let's say, in the previous example where the business was performing at an accuracy level of 95%, we do not execute a BPR project and keep a target of improving the accuracy scores further to 98% or even 100%. While these goals are ideal, there is an inherent possibility that these may cause tremendous pressure of performance on the shop floor, leading to people burnout, dissatisfaction, and huge employee turnover. All of this may further lead to drop in the existing performance and eventually would lead to client dissatisfaction, potential loss to your business, revenue leakage, negative impact on the market share, and much more. So if you think that the process has reached its saturation level, you may want to choose the alternative of executing a BPR project rather than further stressing on improving the performance beyond its saturation levels. It is always advisable to seek professional consultation from a qualified Six Sigma Black Belt or a process improvement expert while you take this decision. With this brief understanding of BPR, let's dig deeper into this topic with an example. In the 1990s, if my father wanted to withdraw cash from the bank, he would get out of the house and walk towards the bank. After reaching the bank, he would fill in the withdrawal slip and collect a token number. He would then wait for the cashier to call out his token number. After his token number was announced, he would then collect the cash. That was the entire process. This process was so cumbersome for consumers that most refrained to keep all their money in the bank accounts. People preferred to keep cash at home in lockers. Banks soon realized that this process was not helping them do effective business. So, they came up with the idea of increasing the number of branches. And hence, you would have observed that in the late 1990s, there was an emergence of banking branches in almost every location. This phenomenon was observed across the globe. But even this did not work. Although the banks tried to come closer to the consumer, they were still operating from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. This was the same time the consumer was busy at work. it looked like a saturated situation for them. Then, some consultants came together and used BPR for this problem. They decided to use technology in the banking business, and you observed the emergence of ATM machines. The launch of ATM machines radically redesigned the cash withdrawal process. Now, the individual just needed to go to the closest ATM machine, swipe his card, and get the money. The previous process steps no longer prevailed. There was a complete technological overhaul in the banking business. This helped in changing the earlier consumer culture. Customers began to keep most of their money in the banks and less cash at home. This is a classic example of BPR. Now, the next question you may have is, what is the difference between BPR and Six Sigma? Let us now do a quick comparison of BPR and Six Sigma. The key focus of BPR is radical redesign of the process, whereas the key focus of Six Sigma is to align and maintain the process. The business drivers for BPR are recession and changing markets. The business drivers for Six Sigma is value-driven customer demands. The goal of BPR is streamlining the process, and the goal of Six Sigma is process alignment. BPR requires a top-down approach for deployment, and Six Sigma requires involvement from the top, middle, and bottom tiers of the organization for its deployment. The impact of a BPR project is generally short and medium term, whereas the impact of Six Sigma project is short, medium, as well as long term. Generally, BPR projects are high risk and low return type of projects. The banking example was an exception where the return was also very high. Six Sigma projects, on the other hand, are generally medium risk and high return type of projects. I hope this comparison was helpful and you have understood BPR in its complete sense. We have now come to the end of this video. Here we learned BPR involves radical redesign of your business process. It is generally used when your business performance level reaches its saturation point. A BPR project leads to improving customer satisfaction, employee satisfaction, and improved business performance. By the end of the video, you also understood the difference between BPR and Six Sigma. If you have witnessed the use of BPR in your business process, I would love to hear those examples. Please share your views in the comment section below. Stay tuned for more such interesting content. Also, please like, share, and subscribe to this channel. I'll see you soon.